Like, I tried a little bit. I was like, it's not my game. That's okay. So, it's like League of Legends. It's not really my game. Oh, character. Oh. I mean, I still like Hero. Right? I still like the main character. But I kind of... This is going to sound really weird, but... I forget his name. The guy that can pull the little balls off his head and, like, super glue them to people. I love how he doesn't seem to be the hero type. He's like a pervy little kid who's just like, I'm doing this with the chicks. And it's like, well, okay. Okay. And I'm hoping they're going to take him and build him up into something really awesome. So I'm keeping an eye on that guy. Keeping an eye on that guy. He's a kid, you know? Kids are horny. Jamie, that'd be just you. Yeah. Now, what I could try to do is... I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna drop the bitrate. And I dropped it by half. So we usually, we started going at 6,000 kilobytes. So I dropped it down to 3,000. And you let me know if you guys are still buffering, because I haven't been able to get transcodes, even though I'm affiliate, still haven't been able to get them. Apparently all the games that I've been streaming, just, they don't get them. And I've just been having a really bad stream of, like, just luck of getting them. So, yeah. Let me know if me dropping my bitrate helps out, though. I'm surprised to see you back. How can I help you? You train police, right? I was told that your dojo trains a lot of people in police. That's right, I train many of them personally. Do you know Akira, a detective, also known as Akechi? From Tokyo. Yes, Detective Tyra. I know him quite well. A man with a great deal of innate talent in martial arts. Though that talent is offset somewhat by his, how do you put this? Brash personality? Oh, no, you could say it. He's an asshole. You could say it. Kiss ass, that sort of thing. You know. I think we're all friends. I think we all can handle that. Brash is a very diplomatic way to put it. Sorry to put you on the spot, but Tyra is about the only usable link I've got left in the police force, and the one person who's trying to stop me the most. Oh, no, we went back to him, Super. Seeing as you train with him all the time, I was hoping you might, know something that would change his mind, if you know what I mean. Are you asking me to help you blackmail? Beyond the obvious reasons why I wouldn't help you do that, I also happen to think it won't work. You may be surprised to hear this, but Detective actually lives a fairly straightforward life. His excesses are nothing that would draw any scrutiny, at least not among his fellow officers. I hear he's engaged to be married soon as well. Someone actually agreed to marry that slime. Yeah, that poor girl! maybe she's just... Maybe he's a sweetheart to her, and then... That's like he's like... That's his rock? Maybe? I don't know. Very nice girl. Apparently they're quite happy together. It's not the hostess from the bar, is it? Well, we'll see how long that lasts. May I ask exactly why you need to make you... Okay, may I ask what exactly Tyra did to make you feel so strongly? You should be asking him that. Ever since I started, he's looked down on me and never missed a chance to remind me how he felt. I ignored him because I figured it would work hard if I worked hard enough and earned my promotion. That would shut him up once and for all. You eventually got that promotion, I take it. Well, did he shut up like you thought? No, he got worse. Started with him spreading rumors about me sleeping around in HQ, then there were various complaints to my supervisor. He couldn't stand that I won. It's all falling apart now, though. He got my old job, and every time I see him, he has that smug grin on his stupid face like he's mocking me. Smack him! So you hate the fact that, at least in his mind, he was right. Something like that, Tyra's not the first person to think a woman didn't deserve the promotion I got, but it stung a little extra when he ended up at my desk. Yeah, I thought as much. You're not saying you think that brown-nosing, womanizing, lazy, good-for-nothing asshole actually deserved my spot, are you? Nope. I can't judge the inner workings of a police force, but from what I've heard, it certainly wouldn't be the first time an officer didn't earn their promotion honestly. Often, I watch my students spar, and I always notice an interesting trend. You see, usually the outcomes of matches have nothing to do with their skill. Is there a moral at the end of the story? Patience. I have patience, just not in games. We've established this. You see, two students will face each other, but before they even draw their swords, they've decided the outcome. Students rank each other and themselves based on practice, their social status, their schools, or any number of things before they even enter my dojo. A student perceiving himself as strong will always be more relaxed, more ready to attack, while the student who's resigned themselves to defeat desperately defends. It's not skill or merit that wins the battle, it's expectations. You see where I'm going with this? I do, but I'm not sure if I like it. You're saying that unless I can break Tyra's perception of me, I'll keep losing. Exactly, for a man like Tyra who expects certain things of women, you defy him at every turn, but if I suck up to him and play the part, it might throw him off guard enough for me to win this fight. Is that about right? Very perceptive. Here, this should help. Sake. It's a gift. It's so flattering, I barely even know you. I suppose in order to degrade myself to scum like Tyra, I could use a drink. It's not for you, it's for Tyra. Oh, and here I was thinking you were being nice. This is a very expensive brand, as a matter of fact, it's Tyra's favorite. Why would he have that, randomly, just sitting around here? A gift for his promotion. A promotion he stole, a promotion into my position. Ooh, grats on 18th, though. Second game was scared, but PUBG's... Oh, you just got an hour ago? Nice. I have noticed that PUBG has changed when it comes to them bailing out of the plane. It seems that within maybe a minute of the match starting, you go from 100 down to a 50. So... I don't know why they did that change, though. It seemed really weird to me when I played a little bit of early access. Think of it as a way to throw him off balance. You can't strike at his heart until he drops his guard. You know how to play the role he expects you to do. I suspect you know that type of woman he likes. Much as it pains me to admit, that might work. Thanks for the sake. Alright. Wait, can I not leave? Kane's like... You are gonna ask every question, whether you like it or not! Ah. The historian. Oh, good, and? What is he? I don't understand your question. He's one of them. That. Are you alright? He's just an old man. What else would he be? No, Takshi, you might have noticed there's something off about him. The noise filter, like static on a television. Is that goes over his body. Do you not see that? Like the collector, but no, not exactly like him. I'm not sure what Yasuhisa told you to scare you like this, but I've known him for years. He's a bit eccentric and too philosophical for his own good, but he's harmless. Alright, Super, you have a great night, brother. Thank you for stopping by. Hope you have a good day tomorrow. Allow me to offer some advice. What you're feeling right now, it's not him. It's you. The more time I spent researching the Kamen Kai in the past, the more I began to feel the world had gone mad. But it didn't. It continued to turn on its axis as it always does. It's me who became unhinged. You could always walk away, Detective. Some mysteries aren't worth solving. Down the bottle, sake! This is a very weird thing, being like, hey, you know what you should be doing? You should placate to the asswipe to then knock the asswipe on the ground. Now, if that's how that's going to work, I'm all for it. But if it's like placate, get something, and then not knock this asswipe down a peg. It's a little bit kind of like, really? I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm sorry. That's it, Ido. I've heard enough of your... Wait, what? You heard it right. I'm sorry. You're a good detective, and I never did congratulate you on your promotion. Here, this is for you. Huh, I get it. So you think bribing me is going to work, huh? Ken no Michi. Is that a bottle of Ken no Michi? No way. Second, welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? I was looking at it, I was like, seconds? Usanama? I'm thinking, I'm going to butcher that last bit. I know I'm going to butcher that last bit. Sorry. Notoriously bad at pronunciations. It's just, hey, you know what? This might get the detective straight down into being, you know, slightly more boozy. That'd be great. It sells out in weeks. Even my family really managed to get a bottle, and they knew the people to ask. How'd you get it? Weird string of events. It's not important. Consider it an apology for how I treated you in the past. I present this to you as a way to formally hand over my old position to you. It's clearly in better hands now. Uh-huh. Bye, but, uh-oh. He's just like, she's bowing. Okay. Ido, sit up, will ya? It's fine. Just sit up already. Okay. I accept your apology. Hell, didn't know how you felt that way. Didn't know you felt that way. I mean, in light of recent events and all, it's long overdue, but guess with all the stress you've gone through, the delay is understandable. Glad you finally learned to manage your emotions properly. Thank you for your kind words, Detective. Once I return to the department, I know I'll have much to learn from you. Hey, it's a little early for that talk, don't you think? We don't even know if they'll let you back on the force after the hearing. Yeah, I suppose you're right. Shouldn't have spoken so rashly. Oh, God. this is just like, it's making him awkward. He's just like, what are you doing? Don't do this. It's out of character. Stop that, please. I always thought you'd be a better cop if you listened to your fellow detectives a bit more. Suppose there's a lot you have to learn from me, eh? I know you're right, Detective. I was so brash before. That's probably how I ended up here. Yeah, no problem. Thanks for dropping this by. To tell you the truth, it's been a tough time for all of us. It's better to stick together. We're all on the same team after all, right? Right. Oh, no, I know. I know, Sega. I love the idea that he just seems like, I just kind of like make him feel awkward and be like, normally she wouldn't even say sorry, so what is she doing? Maybe once you're back, me and you can partner up. One can only hope I'll be so lucky. Right. Look, I gotta get back to my office. My office. You need anything else? Well, I was thinking, but... Oh, no. I couldn't possibly bother you. You're so busy. No, it's fine. I can handle it. Go on. Well, I know you should... I shouldn't be, but I've been doing a little research in an unofficial capacity, you know. I was wondering if you could pull a file for me. You know I can't give you access to the system. You're suspended, and besides, it'd be against regulations, and... I guess if you stay on that side of the counter, I could get Ishibasha to help you. Don't think this means we're best friends or anything. It's just repayment for the Kendomichi. Thank you, but Tyber, or Detective, I wouldn't want to impose on your busy schedule. Again, stand up. I'm going back to my office. Look up the file Idle wants. Log the search query to my name. Got it? Yes, sir. I'll be in my new office after all afternoon, so direct any calls there. Yes, sir. I think he's gone. Damn! I mean, I've twisted some guys around my finger before, but that was something else. Don't think it'll take long to get your office back if you keep working that magic. Oh, that's good. Listen to me very closely. It's very, very important you train me how to do that. For professional purposes. Yes. Very professional. Nothing to do with Bando at all. Not the new guy at all. I think you're right on your own, Saki. Fine. Be that way. Anyway, you got Tyrus sign off. What did you want me to look up for you? On March 4th, 1996, there was a raid on a compound belonging to a cult called the Kamen Kai. I'd like the official report, please, plus anything else you can find on it. That's some heavy reading material. Get on it. Doesn't seem like there's much to go on here. It looks like there's only one file. Alright, I'll put this on the USB for you so you can take with you. Just don't tell anyone. Here you go. Thanks, Saki. Owe you one. You owe me more than one. See you around. Wait, no, actually, yeah, she did catch us breaking into the evidence locker. Still hasn't reported that yet, which is fantastic. Also, while we're at the apartment, we'll take some medication, because the game kept stressing it. Or I can't take any medication or play with my cat. Ah, crap. Okay, never mind. Something doesn't smell right. There's a raid on the compound, and all that's left is this lone debriefing. Doesn't add up. Not to mention so much of what it is here is redacted. Officers arriving at the scene found 12 people dead on arrival, including Tokimasa and Mai's parents. Where are the details about how they died? Not to mention the report itself was filed almost a week after the raid, so why aren't there any autopsy reports? Second, no worry, brothers. Appreciate it, though. Good to have you, though. Says here, 2 children and 1 adult are believed missing. That must be Mai, Takashi, and their grandmother. Guess that means Takashi was telling the truth after all. So many people have been hiding information from me. It's almost a relief. Still, for such a short report, it raises a whole lot of questions. The list of the dead, their causes of death. If there were other survivors, what else they found? It's all lost. Even the location of the compound has been classified. All I know is that the mask was found in the middle of a pile of dead bodies. What the hell happened here? Why was it covered up? Hang on. Date of the incident, approximately 0550. Tasked with raiding compound belonging to cult known as Kamen Kai, located and redacted. Mission details redacted. Arrived to discover 12 bodies, DOA, near compound, including cult leader Shinji Uzumaki. Okay. Other bodies included 6 females and 3 other males of varying ages, along with 2 children. Cause of death redacted. 2 other children and 1 adult considered missing, maybe dead. Other survivors redacted. Professional effects collected at the scene of crime include mask and several other ritual objects. Raid considered a success. Cult known as Kamen Kai's activities have ceased. Surviving members have been rescued? Okay, can it take medication now? We started negative at the beginning of this game. Like, everything was negative. All our stats. We were insane, a wreck, depressed, hyper-nervous. Is bad. It's terrible. Now we're slightly better, so I can take the medication. It should be fine. Just in chat, being here is more than enough for me. Appreciate it, though. The report is unclear, but it's obvious that the mask had a part to play in those 12 people's deaths. A young girl's suicide in Shinjuku made me aware of the dark, and I know now that an ancient mask can be used to find a door that may be the key to getting Kazuki back, which I don't know if you want back. He's going to be dead. Learning about those 2 facets of the mystery was supposed to be enough to show the way to the dark, but even though I can feel the dark, something is still wrong. Peace is still missing. My gut tells me that the missing information I need has to do with what happened to the Kamen Kai. I have to make the Kawakani woman talk. She's the only one alive who could tell me what happened that night. She doesn't like us! And I don't really know why. She passed the curse on to us! It's not really my fault. Alright. Pills the doctor gave me. Yep. And eat these pills. Yes! Alright! Nobody's died so far. I'm still expecting someone to die. Okay, sanity's not that bad. Negative 21. Neurosis, really, really terrible. Can I pet the kitty? Nope. I can't. I love how the game's like, no. Your stats are gonna be here. Okay. Alright, let's go talk to Grandma. Grandma loves me. No, she doesn't. Very bipolar woman here. First she's like, you're my savior, then you're my, you know, my devil, and then you're like my savior, and then, yeah. You, I told you to stay away from my family. Don't drag my grandchildren into this any more than you already have. Stay back. I have questions about the Kamen Kai, the group your daughter and son-in-law were part of. You're the only one alive who'd remember. Kamen Kai, I don't know anything about it. Leave me alone. Just Grandma, enough. Listen to yourself. Do you even realize you're lying anymore? Years of just pathological lying. She's just like, that's all she knows. Takashi told us everything. And you, just because this investigation's important to you, doesn't give you the right to barge in here. Oh, the door was open. Your grandma and I need to talk. If it upsets you, maybe you should go. No, I'm not going anywhere. This is the house I grew up in. It's as much mine as it is grandma's. If you have something to say, you can say it in front of me. Only a little while ago, I found out my parents died in some cult, and no one even knows why. You think hearing that was easy for me? No, I don't. I want to help you, but all the deceit and lies are starting to hurt people. What I'm chasing is so much worse. Tell that to the poor man in the station. He's in the hospital now, terrified out of his wits. Okay, all we did was grab a corpse of a dead crow and went like this in front of his face. He passed out because he saw blood. Now, that's so much better than her wanting to use force and maybe break his arm. People aren't only here to be used for information and then thrown away while you move on. They have lives, too. I know. That was the better of the two options. Like, I don't want to break the guy's arm. I mean, he was being a dick. He was actually going way past his station, like, acting like a security guard. Well, actually, like a police officer when he has no right to. So, man. Bringing up the past can hurt. Surely you, of all people, understand that. I do, but ignoring the past won't make it go away, and there's some unfinished business from the Kamen Kai that needs to be taken care of. But what's left to talk about? Everyone's dead, right? Mai, I promise to talk to you about all this later. For now, let me and the detective talk. Go on, you were cooking us dinner, weren't you? Get back in the kitchen! Alright, we'll talk about it later. But I'll be in the other room if you need me. So you found me out. Now that Mai knows, I suppose there's no point in keeping a secret any longer. Alright, are you gonna spill? Because that'd be fantastic. The truth is, my daughter never would have joined the Kamen Kai if it weren't for me. I convinced her and her husband to join? I was a...
You were the member?
Oh! Your daughter was getting her... She had a master's degree, was working on her PhD. Her husband had multiple master's degrees. These were intelligent people. And they trusted the wrong person. They trusted grandma. At the time I joined, my husband had left me and had lost my job, suddenly leaving me a single, unemployed mother who could barely support her daughter. That's when Tokimasa found me and told me that the society that stigmatized and shunned me was a fiction, a great machine to be fought, and that my very soul was at stake. Of course, he used me as he did everyone else. I desperately wanted to hear that my struggles weren't my fault. They stole everything from me, my youth, my mind, then my child. And then one day, in 1996, they all died. The cause of death was buried, and no autopsies were performed. Or if they were, they were hidden. Why? That's simple. The government didn't care about some dead cultists in the woods and covered it up so the papers wouldn't sensationalize their deaths. That's it? After everything I've found, you expect me to believe that? 12 people died that day, and no one knows why. What happened? Tell me the truth. You want to know what happened so badly? Fine, I'll tell you. I mean, that's why I asked the first time. Exactly. Plot twist. They died for nothing, following in the footsteps of a madman who believed that life was an illusion. As words of other compounds and other groups being raided spread, Tokimasa began warning us that the end was near. He believed the world was collapsing and it was time for him and his followers to abandon the flesh and find purity among the gods. My Emiko, she didn't die from some conspiracy. She chose death because she no longer had an anchor to reality, and it was my fault. Beyond that, I don't know what happened to them. No, you do know something. In the report, it says after the officers cleared the bodies, they found the mask. The same one you handed me 6 months ago. Wait, it's been 6 months? Yeah, it kind of adds up a little bit. Tokimasa would have always kept it to himself, saying it granted him sight into the realm of the Kami. I needed it. You don't understand. It allowed us to see strange things in people who were gone. The guru was a fool, a fake, but the mask was real. There was a rumor that the cult members were killed by one of their own. Surely you didn't. No. You don't understand. I would never kill my own child. I didn't take the mask. It was given to me. Uh-oh. Remember how we lost control of our body? Grandma might have lost control of her body. One day, a man, some journalist or other, showed up at my door carrying the mask. I couldn't believe it. I begged him for it, and he stood there, smiling at me. His eyes were like none I'd ever seen. It was strange. All he wanted in exchange for the mask was a picture of Emiko. The collector. What? Why does the collector have any importance in this? Like, it's like he's stirring the pot. Like, you know what? There's not enough chaos right now. Let's go find somebody. Let's throw the mask at somebody. Watch the shit hit the fan. When I joined the cult, I was forced to give him my possessions and only had one left, but I gave it to him nevertheless. I thought if I had the mask that I could find her, that maybe she would forgive me. As soon as I had it in my hands, my mind opened. I could hear her voice. And give me a second, guys. Alright. Telemarketers. Gotta love them. So you went to the sewers chasing after her, thinking you could save her. Okay, I love how the collector gives you a choice. Do you hold on to the memory of the person you love? Or do you chase after something that's now been corrupted by darkness and is essentially evil, right? Just to somehow physically touch them. Even if it's not really them anymore. Takasha told you that as well, did he? Yes, it's true. Emiko was crying out to me, begging me to find her and free her from a dark place. I would have given anything to hold her in my arms again, plead her forgiveness. I don't care if you don't believe me. Just like Tanaka was calling out to me. I do believe you. We're probably some of the few people left alive who know what this mask is capable of. If you really thought it'd help you find her, then why'd you give it to me? Why'd you give it to me? Because I was wrong. At first, I only followed whispers. Then I found myself in a strange labyrinth, chasing after her shade. The days bled together. I lost track of my grandchildren, of the shrine. It was an illusion. No matter how hard I tried, I never found her. I only became more and more disconnected from the world around me. I descended into madness. I was being used again, just as Tokimasa had used me so many years before. I tried getting rid of it, throwing it away, burning it. None of it mattered. It always came back. When I did, the visions and whispers only got worse. So I put it out of my mind and tried as best as I could to live a life of solitude and ignore the screams of my daughter. Oh! You wake up, think it's your alarm. Oh, it's your daughter screaming in the darkness. Crap. Then you came. And when you did, the mask was screaming out in voices I'd never heard before. I thought it was a sign, so I gave it to you. I didn't even have time to breathe out a sigh of relief before I heard a gunshot ring out. No one else ran to it. I think I was the only one who knew that sound for what it was. I thought the mask was punishing me once again by taking my away from me. Instead, it had passed tragedy to another. I'm sorry. Perhaps the knowledge of the mask should die with us. There is one other person who knows about the mask, a girl named Rena. Does that name mean anything to you? No, I don't know anybody by that name. Do you expect me to know everyone who's been touched by the mask? No, but you were involved with the group that worshipped it. Are you sure you're telling me everything? Yes. What good will accusing an old woman do? I don't know. I can kind of accuse you for a lot right now. Unless you're chasing someone too. That must be it. Mai told me you lost someone. Your partner in the police, is that right? If I'm right, then I suggest you stop your search. The place I was shown by the mask was not meant for the living. I barely escaped with my life. Stop while your mind and body remain intact. What if I told you there was another option? What other option? Stick it in the closet? Forget about it? In the months since I first met you, I've had time to examine the ancient texts in the shrine. And as the mask grew further away, it loosens its grip on my mind. I knew then it would someday make its way back to me, so I became determined to find a way to protect myself and my grandchildren.